Good. Come on back. Don't run away with our sweater. Now, you actually watch the show.
I do.
What's wrong with you?
I guess I have too much time on my hands.
So do we. You know what? So do we. We're doing some market research for the Gap. Okay. Would you mind trying it on? Seeing how it feels, how it fits? How would it feel? Because we want to see if, like, we're looking for the swingers look. If you would undo one button, perhaps, just to see how it looks. Okay, two buttons. One more. Give it one more. You guys, it's tough to convince. Okay, this is, you know what, because this is the first person in Ottawa that's seen our show. So what we want you to do, yeah, take it off so all the girls in Ottawa can see you.
Well,
and
that's why I wanted to be on TV. I wanted to pick up some chicks.
That's why we wanted to be on TV. It doesn't work, okay? Would you mind just taking it off nice, smooth,
really
and sexy? Like,
really
so the ladies in Ottawa know what they're getting into, you know what I'm saying?
I'm single, too, by the way.
To say this is your telepersonal thing, what do you like to do?
What would I like to do? I'm big on country music. I drive a really cool car.
What kind of car?
Pontiac Bonneville.
Is that good? Is that a good car? I can't remember.
I've also got a Mustang convertible.
You put the Bonneville. I drive a K car. Oh, but I got a Ferrari back home. Okay, we're doing a new segment on the Buzz. It's called The Buzz Playboy Profile.
Well, you're gonna get the guy to take off the jacket.
We will.
After they know what I like.
What are your likes?
Well, let's see. Like a good movie, big on cars, lots of music, and I watch lousy Community 22 shows.
What are your dislikes?
Dislikes. Chicks who swear and spit.
That's what you don't. is that?
Those are men.
I'm new to that. Chicks with male genitalia named Frank. I hate that.
With a mustache.
So those are your likes or dislikes. What would an ideal date with MC Cowpie be?
Dinner, movie, and maybe something else.
Oh. Ladies of Ottawa, if you like what you see, I don't know. Call the number, and maybe we can set you guys up. MC Cowpie, take it off. Waka chicka, waka chicka, waka chicka, waka 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 chicka. Big moment for me. I just wet my pants. Rob Schneider, how's it going, bro?
Hi, Daryn, good to see you. Pleasure.
Thanks for reading my name tag to get the name right.
My pleasure, Daryn.
I appreciate that.
Jones.
Exactly. Now, I want to ask you something.
Media.
I mean, you come to all these festivals.
Yes, I do.
People want to piece you up.
I come to all these festivals.
You come to a lot.
Daryn.
You do. You're going to be doing, like, card trade shows soon, aren't you?
Yes, but only that. Card trade shows and
Star Trek conventions?
All right, Star Trek conventions, but that's it.
You'd make a very beautiful Klingon, if I may say. I noticed before you were talking to the guy who played Skippy on Family Ties. Was it hard? Was it hard?
Be nice.
I am being nice.
Daryn, when you turn like 22 and you're still in the business, then we'll talk. And
that's years away, man.
Then you can on anybody you want. Come on, are you going to say something mean about Skippy?
No, not at all.
Oh, all right, what are you going to say?
Did you enjoy his work?
Oh.
I can't believe I'm getting reprimanded for making fun of people from the guy who does it for his whole career.
Well, who do I ever make fun of?
Come on, we saw the Saturday Night Live thing. Photocopier people all around the world.
It's like 5 years ago.
Going, you bastard, bastardino.
I never said bastard. You know it, and I know it. He makes things up. I don't know how he got this job. When this guy gets his braces off, look out, because he's going to be something. He's a mover and a shaker. He's a kid with a dream, and he's in my way. And if he continues to get in my way, I'm going to stomp him. Let me give you a little clue. There's a thing that they have now in show business called makeup. You know, it's like powder, and it's not that expensive. You can buy it yourself.
Yeah? I should invest?
No, don't go for it. It's $1, $1.50. A little powder, a little paint. Makes Daryn what he ain't, you know?
Hey, buzzers. Right now, we got Reggie McFadden. You've seen this guy on In Living Color. You've seen this guy on Keenan Ivory Wayans, Def Jam. This guy's done so much stuff. This guy's like one of my favorite comedians. Reggie, how you doing, man? What's going on now? What's going on now with you? I saw you on Keenan. That was recently.
I'm doing David Letterman again. I was supposed to do it last week. I don't know when you're going to show this, but I'm
like 2 years from now.
Right? I was supposed to do it last week. No.
Freeze. This interview is just way too serious for Buzz. What we need to do is take this interview and make it into a stand-up comedy show.
Welcome to Moe's Def Jam Interviews. starring Tony Woods, from In Living Color, Reggie McFadden, Roz Brown, Lonnie Love, and you've seen this guy in The Nutty Professor, Con Air, and starring in Half-Baked, Dave Chappelle. Whoa, 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 but we didn't get Dave Chappelle? Okay, we don't have Dave Chappelle, but you know what? We got his mother. Yeah, so do you have kids here, you're saying, right?
Yeah, I got kids. I got two of them, one 12, one 9. I just don't have a wife. I had a wife.
What happened?
Got rid of her.
Can you give me like a joke that you do in your act?
I'm or married.
An example? You're married?
Yeah, that's a joke in itself. He has kids, you know, he didn't tell me about all these kids. He got four kids.
For other women?
Yeah, not by me.
But you're just lazy. You wanted kids and everything, but you didn't want to have them yourself. That's what it is.
No, he had it, but when he met me, he told me he had one, but he had four. He gonna tell me it was one with four different names.
And you're from?
I'm from Detroit, and I have worked in an automobile factory, and I'm here to tell anybody, if you're driving a 1995 Chevrolet Cutlass, take the car back, because I built it, okay? From Detroit.
That was so funny. Tell us a little bit about Dave that we don't know. Nothing embarrassing, unless you want to, but something about Dave that we don't know.
Well, I can only say that I've been a fan of his for many, many years, as long as he's been alive.
What's up, everyone? We're in Montreal meeting new friends. This is
Simone
from New York, right?
Long Island,
New York. I want to ask you, are you married, Simone?
No, I'm divorced.
Divorced?
Yeah.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Why?
I don't know. I figure you have to say that. It's when you hear people die and are divorced, you have to say, I'm sorry.
Oh, you do?
I could give a crap. I mean, yeah. I figure I may score tonight.
It's better when you're divorced, believe me.
Really? How come?
Because you don't have to be some man's slave, you know?
Yeah, unless you're into that sort of thing. So what are you doing in Montreal?
We are on a shoot.
What kind of shoot?
A modeling shoot.
Oh, are you the model?
No, my daughter's the model.
She covers up her face. It's my daughter, the elephant lady. Simone, have you ever thought of modeling?
I used to model.
I believe it.
Long time ago.
I got a question for you.
A long time ago.
I got a question. She's a fox. Get a good look. Get a good long look at her. She's a fox. drink her up, Canada. Take a long drink of water, baby. What's your name?
Oh, my name is Lindsay.
Lindsay. Now, Lindsay's a model.
Yes.
How long have you been modeling?
A couple years.
And a couple years.
She's only like two.
What do you spend your money on?
Lots of stuff.
Like what?
Prada, Miu Miu, Versace.
Pampers. What's your favorite flavor of Gerber's?
Whatever.
String carrots. You like the string carrots?
No, I'm not into that stuff.
Wow. So you go to the school for the blind and crippled,
yeah.
And no boys chase you.
No.
How about the modeling guys? They're like 38, and they're like, I can get you a blind girl. You're on 17 now. How did you get into modeling? For all our fans out there.
I just went to an open call, and it was that easy.
You know what Mo had to do to get on this show?
Hey, it's a terrible experience. I don't want to remember. I blocked that out of my memory.
How much do you like white boys?
Hey.
Can you do some modeling, like walk? Can you teach me how to walk like a model?
You want to walk like a model?
Come on, get up. No. Mo, come on over here, man.
No hips?
Keep the stomach in. Stomach in, no hips.
Ooh la la.
That was good. Okay, Mo, your turn. Yeah, I've noticed models are always angry. They're always like...
You don't want to take, attention off the clothes.
What clothes? I've watched fashion television. They, put two coins on a nipple, and they're done.
Like I've ever watched.
All right, so, Mo, you want to do the walk?
I'll do the walk for you. Tell me if I'm doing anything wrong.
Okay, go ahead.
No hips, and... Okay, Naomi. Huge honor here on The Buzz. I'm here with Emmanuel Lewis. Emmanuel, how you doing, buddy?
I'm doing great. Excellent.
All right. What brings you to Montreal?
I come here to enjoy the festivities, be a host for the show tomorrow, I believe, and have some fun, mainly.
Now, do you tell jokes?
I hope so.
I got a question for this guy.
All right.
You tell jokes? I can't hear anything.
That's Mo. He's a little slow.
Is he?
Yeah. Okay. What's your best joke? What's a big joke you're going to lay out tomorrow night?
I don't know. You know, a fart joke is, you know, always underrated. You know?
A fart joke?
A good fart joke. You know what I mean? You know what I mean?
What's your best joke? I can't hear anything.
How old were you when the show Webster was on?
I have no idea. It was just like I was really young, so I really...
How old are you now?
I never tell.
Oh, you're ageless.
I'm ageless.
Oh, man.
I'm trying to be like Dick Clark or something. That's my goal.
That would be a wicked show, Webster and Dick Clark together. That would be awesome. Mo?
How old are you now? No one's asked the question yet. Do you still keep in touch with the white folks? They're on that show. Any chance?
Yeah.
The white folks. We had a reunion on Vibe, so that was really nice with Sinbad.
You know what you should
Sinbad.
Do? You should have like a reunion on Vibe.
That's
what's
right.
Wrong? I can't hear
That's
the guy.
Right, you said.
You're like our best audience all night. You laugh at everything.
He's funny over here.
He's very funny. Don't pay any attention to him. He's really annoying. We have him on the show for a quotient. You know what I'm saying?
Ah, right.
A little quota. A little,
right.
Little Canadian government on our back. You know what I'm saying?
No problem. You know what I mean? Get in when you fit in. That's all. That's
I
all.
I heard that
about.
One.
It's like looking in the mirror, eh, Mo?
Yeah. I heard that one.
Really? Great. Well, dude, thank you very much for being on the show. It's a huge honor. Thank you very much. Best of luck to you. There's Mo.
Hey, this is Mr. Mo, and I'm standing out here on the street here, and this attractive girl came up here just like walking around, and she spotted us, and her name is Tara. Tara, am I right?
Oh, yes, it is.
And you're like Electric Circus girl, EC dancer.
Yes, I am.
Okay, since you're down here, right, do you want to hang out with me for the rest of the day?
Sure.
Right
yeah.
Now? Well,
yeah.
You know, let's go.
All right.
If you would like to comment on The Buzz, you can call our viewer response line at 1-800-939-RSVP. Or you can check out The Buzz's website at www.globalserve.net/squigglylinebuzztv. Or you can write to The Buzz, care of Rogers Community Television, 855 York Mills Road, Don Mills, Ontario, M3B 1Z1.